Oh. I thought you'd change your mind.
Did you?
If I were in your place, I think I'd be a little curious, too. Want a drink? I have your husband's favorite brand.
No, thank you.
All right, you're late and I'm going to a cocktail party, so I'll wind this up fast. I'm back and I'm going to stay back.
That is no longer a matter of concern to my husband or myself.
Did you stand outside the door rehearsing that?
No, it came easily because it's true.
I'm not especially interested in marrying Bran anymore.
Oh, you have other means of support?
Better means. It would just be simpler if you'd let him go. But if you don't, I want to tell you what to expect. This time it's going to be different. This time he's not going to sneak a few minutes with me when he can get away from you. This time you'll see him only when I don't want him. Is that clear?
You're not difficult to follow.
Sorry I'm not more subtle. But you must remember, I haven't had your advantages. When your mother was busy being the great lady of the theater, mine was in a burlesque show on 14th Street. And when your mother sent you to Miss Cavanaugh's school for nice young ladies, I was slinging hash. Oh, you learned how to pour tea properly and how to cross your legs at the ankles only. And that plain pumps make you a lady, but putting bows on them make you something else. You learned how to make a good marriage. But like all your kind, you think by marrying a man you've done enough. Well, there's one thing Miss Cavanaugh forgot to teach you. Something I learned. How to keep a man, how to keep him wanting you.
My husband doesn't want you. He's finished with you. He told me so last night.
I'll call him and he'll come running.
Do you know how he thinks of you?
Roughly.
As a sickness.
And what do you stand for? Health? Sacred and profane love, huh?
If Bran wants you, why doesn't he leave me? I'd let him go. He knows that. But he begs me to stay with him. Why?
He's told me why over and over again. For the same reason he married you.
Because he loves me.
Because he wanted a check rein, a control, a straitjacket. And that's what you are to him. Because he's a little afraid to be himself.
You're a little afraid too, aren't you?
Of what, of you?
Why else did you call me? Because you're not sure of yourself. Because you know you've lost Bran. This is one last desperate try, isn't it? You're afraid and unhappy, and perhaps that's only fair. You've caused me a great deal of unhappiness in the past. But if I were in your place, I would remember something Miss Cavanaugh didn't forget to teach me. How to lose gracefully.